Welcome RPA Champions. In today's video, I'm going to be showing you something really fun. We're going to be putting together Microsoft Power Automate Desktop and AI and create an automation that is going to comment on posts automatically on LinkedIn. But it's not just going to stupidly comment on all different comments. It is going to take the name of the person, it's going to take the content, it is going to use a glorified prompt to work it on ChatGPT, and after it has done all of this, it is going to create a comment. It's not just going to create a comment. Obviously, it's going to like the post, it is going to change the profile with which we are posting, and then it's going to make the comment. And the best part of this is that it is going to go until infinity or until we decide, because it's an automation, it is a robot that is doing this job. On the RPA Champions channel, this is the kind of stuff that we do. So if you are new here, don't forget to subscribe and smash the like button, because my videos are about automation, are about bringing awareness to everybody about how easy it is to create automations like this that can automate manual and repetitive tasks and also automate cognitive reasoning tasks with AI. And this is a perfect example of how we bring these two technologies together. We automate manual and repetitive tasks by using this free technology from Microsoft Power Automate Desktop that allows us to click, to move, to pretty much do all of the repetitive things that we do on our computer. And then we combine it with AI. We combine it with AI so that we can get some cognitive action inside of our process. And this example is a perfect example. Why? Because we're creating a comment to a post that is based on the content of that post. Therefore, the comment is going to be always relevant, engaging, and so on. Now, in addition to this, I wanna just let you know that I have left a surprise for you. I have left two LinkedIn learning trainings from me entirely for free, focused on Microsoft Power Automate Desktop, Advanced and Basic. I highly recommend that you take these trainings so that you, in a structured way, learn how to use Microsoft Power Automate Desktop and can create amazing automations. Now, with all of this said, you should also give yourself a high five, because learning these skills is going to truly give you a competitive advantage and make you much more productive. With all of this said, let's jump into Microsoft Power Automate Desktop and see how to build this automation. Now, let's jump into Microsoft Power Automate Desktop and let me show you how this process is built so that you can build it yourself. In addition to this, I'm going to leave you the code in the Discord channel or down in the links below so that you can copy and paste it and then just fine tune it for your own needs. Let's go over the different actions. Inside of the process, I have grouped the process inside of different regions to make it a little bit more easier to understand what is going on inside of the process. We're going to start the process by asking the user to input some text inside of a input box. This text is going to be then taken and inserted inside of a dynamic link. So we're going to open a new Google Chrome instance, and inside of the keywords, this link right here, we're going to add the user input. This is going to be a dynamic variable that is generated from the display input dialog that is going to populate this field with the keyword that we insert. Now, after that, we are going to navigate to the same page. This is done because opening the same page with certain filters on LinkedIn doesn't work, but it does work if you navigate then to that link, we would get the filters applied. Just to show you what I mean by this, these filters, you will not be able to see them if you just open the page. However, if you navigate to this page, you will be able to see these filters. Going on, we start a loop. So we decide how many comments or posts do we want to make, from 0 to 10. We can also make 100 posts. After that, we scrape the data. So we scrape the profile name of the person, and then we click on more if it's there, and then we scrape the content of the post. There is a little bit of fine tuning to make here. Let me show you what I mean. If I go inside of the UI elements and I click on this first connector, we're going to see that this connector has been fine tuned and is also using a loop index. This loop index is going to be a dynamic variable that is going to change every time the ordinal or the loop index variable changes, and is going to change the ordinal of this element as well, so that we can click on the next one, on the next one, on the next one, and so on. This took a little bit of fine-tuning, and probably if you set this up, you are going to also have to fine-tune these selectors. Make sure that the selector with the resolution that you are looking at has the same number of divs, has this ID that it has right here, and also that you are using the ordinal value in the right element. Now, once we have managed to scrape the information, we have to do a little bit of cleaning inside of this information. This information can contain different signs such as at, apostrophe, slashes, and we cannot pass all of this information to ChatGPT, otherwise we're going to get an error. So we are going to set this information, set up a variable, and put this information inside of a variable. After that, we're going to use that variable and just replace some text. Let me show you this replace text action. It is going to take the post content, it is going to search for these elements, and then we're going to use a regular expression and replace it with two dots. The same is going to be done for the post. We're going to search for these elements and remove all of that special characters from the title and from the content. After that, we are going to create our variable that is going to be used. If we look inside of the prompt variable, we're going to see that right here we're going to have our prompt that is going to be passed to ChatGPT and is going to generate an answer. This prompt is using two dynamic variables that we have created inside of our flow. Let's read this. Provide a coincide comment on the post by author, and then we have the scraped name of the author that we have, with the length of one or two sentences. Ensure the comment is relevant and adds value to the discussion. Avoid include any trailing sentences or unnecessary detail in the output. The content of the post is this. And then we have the content that we have scraped from the post. Now, once we have this variable, it is still not enough. Why? Because the information that we are going to get is going to have some spaces and some line breaks. So what we have to do is we have to replace all of the different line breaks. After we have done that, we have a escaped text content, which is our final prompt. Inside of the invoke web service, we're going to make a call to ChatGPT. We are going to make a URL to this call right here with post application JSON, our bearer token, and this is the message of that we are going to be sending to ChatGPT. So this is going to be the system, and right here inside of the content, I have a long instruction prompt. Basically, this instruction prompt is telling ChatGPT how it is going to write its messages, it's putting it into context, and it's giving it some guidelines on how to make creative, dynamic, provoking comments that people are going to engage with. After that, we are going to remember to turn on the encode request body, and then we're going to save the invoke web service. However, for the invoke web service, it is not enough from ChatGPT to just get the response and convert to JSON. We have to do a couple of steps. We have to run a PowerShell script that is going to take this JSON or this text variable that we have saved as a JSON response and output the content. And this is going to output the response just like we want it. So it is going to select from the JSON the choices, the message 0, and that is going to be the output that we are looking for. Once we have generate the AI content, we are finally ready to post our content. However, before posting our content, we want to make sure that we are in the right place on the page. So what we are going to do is we're going to focus on that part of the page and also perform a click just to make sure that we are there. After that, we are going to click on the icon that is going to allow us to change the user. We're going to wait for 4 seconds. We're going to select the user that we want, and then we're going to click save. And now, finally, we are ready to make the post. We're going to click on like the post, click on the comment button, and then with send keys, output the PowerShell output, which is our response from ChatGPT. And once this has been inserted, we are going to click on the post, and the post is going to create our comment. In addition to this, I have added a skip, which is going to serve me for different exceptions that I have inside of my flow. So if some of these exceptions fail, we're going to skip to the end of the loop and just go to the next action. While I have also created a couple of other subflows that make it easier for me to collect more data and make this flow more stable and be able to work more different cases. Because what you're going to see is that on LinkedIn, the pages has different kinds of content. Some content has a post detail, some is just the name, some just has some hashtag, some has the more button. So in this process, I have managed to include all of these kinds of exception and be able to create a post pretty much infinitely until forever. Let's give this a run and see how it works. So we are going to input a search field such as the RPA champion. Let's see if we can find anything on LinkedIn for the RPA champion. I highly doubt so, but we've already been able to find something for RPA, I guess, intelligent process automation. There is some stuff. So as you can see now in this first part, in the first page, we didn't have these filters, but when we navigate, we are able to see this filter. Now, what the next step of the automation is going to be to focus on the comment and then on the SVG, as we have seen. Now it's going to change from my name to Pugliai, under which I want to make the post. After that, it is going to click on the like and then on the comment, and it is going to leave a comment that is going to be AI generated. Now let's see this comment in action and see what it is going to come up with. The fusion of intelligent process automation with effective change management is essential for driving sustainable change, operational excellence in today's competitive landscape. Well, great post. I could fine tune this to make it more engaging, more provoking, to have it in a different tone of voice, such as a Shakespeare tone of voice, or I could just go around trolling all kinds of different content, showing how AI is taking over people and how you don't really know if what you are reading is makes sense or not. Now, if you have stayed with me, smash the like button to give me a positive sign that you want more videos like this, and also don't forget to subscribe to the channel so that you don't miss any more automations like this. It has been a pleasure, like always, showing you this amazing automations. Keep in mind that this automation skills are going to be very, very important, and it's very important for you to learn these skills. I've been working in this industry for over a decade and a half, and I have seen how the work inside of organizations is changing very, very rapidly. And that is also one of the reasons of my YouTube channel. My YouTube channel is created to raise awareness about this kind of technologies and how you can, in first person, learn these technologies before they automate you as well. And one more time, I hope that you have enjoyed this video, and give yourself a high five because you are truly amazing. Thank you so much for watching my video, and I will see you in the next one.